Tonight with Arnab Goswami. This is the News Hour.
She gave the center a 72-hour ultimatum, her threat roll back or face the consequences. But today, as all eyes are on Mamata Banerjee, sources are telling your channel that the TMC chief is herself in a big dilemma. Should she outrightly pull the plug? Should she withdraw her ministers yet support the UPA? Most likely that will happen. Or should she revise her demand and start bargaining? Pressure is growing on Mamata from within her party to reconsider her ultimatum. Some don't want her to give up the railway ministry. The union government officially at least has stuck to its stand of no rollback in fuel hikes or FDI, so they are not making it easier for Mamata to get a face saver. Now all eyes are on the big decision tomorrow at her party's all-important parliamentary meeting.
Trinamool headquarters in Kolkata is abuzz. A day ahead of the all-important parliamentary party meeting. The temperamental Trinamool chief is now facing a huge dilemma.
Mamata Banerjee is holding her cards very close to her chest. These options have been discussed. She is talking to her senior leaders, her close confidants, and she is trying to reach a consensus on these issues. Which way should the TMC go now? Because time and again, Mamata Banerjee has threatened that she would quit the government on various issues, but that did not happen. But this time around, for Mamata, it is so far and not farther. And so she has to take a decision either this way or that.
Can withdraw and support from outside? Being in the ministry, we won't attend office. These two and third one is that totally we can walk out from UPA. These three things we will discuss.
The government categorically making it clear that there would be no reversal of decision on reforms.
The opposition which opposes the decision will demand the rollback. But did anyone in government give you the impression that we are rolling it back? But as far as I know, we are not rolling back any of those decisions.
But efforts are on to pacify its ally on the eve of TMC's decisive meet.
मुझे पूरा भरोसा है कि जब ममता जी और उनके MPs इस बात को FDI की बात को विस्तार से सोचेंगे गहराई से सोचेंगे तो जरूर वो महसूस करेंगे कि जब तक देश के साधन जुटाए नहीं जाएं और बढ़ाए नहीं जाएं तो हम किस तरह से आम आदमी की आशाओं पर खरे उतरेंगे
Mamata has 6 ministers in the cabinet and withdrawing them will mean losing out on key portfolios that will lessen her bargaining power The move is, however, being encouraged by the opposition.
अब ममता जी है अरे भाई पिछली बार एफडीआई ने उस महिला ने रोक के बताया है कैबिनेट में पास हो गया था और आकर उस महिला ने रुकवाने का काम
It's a huge test to Mamata Banerjee's populist politics, with the government likely to push more reforms in the coming days. The Trinamool chief has to make up her mind quickly. With Jayanta Bhattacharya in Kolkata, Murali Tharan for Times Now. On the News Hour tonight, will the government be able to push bold reforms in the face of pressure from opposition and allies?
Well, before we begin our debate tonight, just a quick couple of questions to Jayanta Ghoshal, senior journalist of the Anand Bazar Patrika Group. Is she or is she not going to pull back? What do you think, Mr. Ghoshal? What would you bet on?
I think, Arnav, what you said at the very beginning, I completely support and endorse your view that she will not withdraw the support from the government. She is not ready to destabilize the government and she knows that if she withdraws, in spite of her withdrawal, the government will last. And what she told privately that she doesn't want to be Prakash Karat of UPA 2.
Okay.
That means when Prakash Karat did it on the nuke deal, in spite of that, Manmohan Singh's government survived. Now, Mayawati, Mulayam, Mamata, if three of this, I mean the party, the, if they withdraw simultaneously, then the government can fall. Otherwise, she knows that if she withdraws the support, the government will continue. Number two, she told me, personally she told me, that there is a difference between your strategy and tactics. She is now talking like communist. The communists also say that strategy and tactics, there is a difference. The strategy is to stop the FDI in retail because ideologically we are against it. In our manifesto we opposed it, and but tactically we should do what we should do, because tactically we can withdraw the ministers. But if we withdraw the support, the government will not fall.
Okay.
And she doesn't want any confrontation with the Congress government, because as a federal structure,
well, then it's pretty clear to me.
To continue as chief minister,
well, then it's
she needs the security from
absolutely.
The Home Ministry for the Maoist operation. Lot of things are there.
So what
I should say, Arnab, tomorrow I think the divorce will not take place, but some sort of separation may take place tomorrow.
Well, that is a separation which we have heard about for a long time. This divorce never happens. Not that we are trying to engineer a divorce. Join the coach. I'll stay on. Let's welcome into our debate now Ravi Shankar Prasad, Deputy Leader of the Opposition. Of the Rajya Sabha, who's also joining our panel. Let's open up. We have a big panel tonight. Atul Anjan, National Secretary of the Communist Party of India. Delighted to see Kiran Majumdar Shaw, Chairman and Managing Director of Biocon, one of India's best known and most respected entrepreneurs, industrialists. Kumar Ketkar of the Bhaskar Group is with me in the studio. Professor Rajiv Gowda, thank you very much. And of course, Gaurav Bhatia of the Samajwadi Party. Ms. Kiran Majumdar Shaw, what do you make of it? This entire logjam that we have found ourselves in. The government was told for the last 1 year policy paralysis. They move an inch and then you have so many noises against what they have done. Do you think this government will be able to find the way forward?
Well, you know, first and foremost, Arnab, I personally believe that these economic measures should have been announced 4 years ago. At a time when the Indian economy was booming, at a time when the aviation sector was flying high. Because let's not forget that these measures actually have a gestation of at least 4 to 5 years before they bear fruit. If we had taken these steps, at a time when I said it should have been, today you would have seen huge capital flows. You would have then seen your rupee at not the low levels that it is today. Our oil bills would have been 30% lower. And we wouldn't have had this high inflation rate, and our economy would be in a much stronger GDP growth position. You know, let's not forget that we all talk about Aam Aadmi, and Aam Aadmi needs 10% GDP growth for any future. And if government does not realize this, if the opposition government does not realize this, and if they think that this can happen without FDI, I think they're kidding themselves.
Okay, let's get two politicians pitted against your point of view right at the start, and then we'll go into the bigger debate. Let's get on the other side. First, let's begin the debate by putting Ravi Shankar Prasad and Atul Anjan with the views of Kiran Majumdar Shaw. So my question to you is, Atul Anjan, you know, you want the growth in your states, but when it comes to the center, you have a completely different policy. You welcome Big Bazaar in West Bengal.
No.
You welcome Big Bazaar in West Bengal. You welcome Walmart in Punjab. You welcome Walmart in Chhattisgarh. I mean, what is this but complete hypocrisy?
I don't consider your words to be very serious one. In the Big Bazaar is something different and Walmart is something different. But in Punjab or Chhattisgarh, we never invited Walmart and all that. But the very point, very interesting point that Kiran has made, that she has given a very rosy picture. And a picture that 4 years back we have did like this, we could have done like this, the present situation would have not been. Even if we would have done 4 years back, the Kingfisher have met the same fate which has met today. Because they don't think the private sector means big good management. You are taking all the Miss Worlds here and there at the cost of Indian exchequer. Naturally, your this aviation jaunt will certainly see the ground. And I think number one and number two and number three, like
one
this,
minute.
That yes, 10% growth Aam Aadmi wants. What sort of, you see, you are selling the ideas. Aam Aadmi wants two chapatis and a half...
What is the rationale? I don't understand.
How much of, you see, pulses and some green vegetables and 10% from there. Do you think that 8% growth has brought two points of, you see, Sensex in their life? No, nothing. Nothing has happened like that.
No, you didn't answer my question. You didn't answer my question. But one second, sir. One second, sir. I'll tell you one thing.
You have given a long rope to tell you. Then you should listen that.
My question was different.
Showing the other side of the coin. She doesn't understand the 77% people are below poverty line and BPL and APL.
When there was discomfort in the CPIM, which was your ally party, over inviting Indonesia Salim Group to invest in Nandigram? Right? Because the group was associated...
Yes, we opposed it. You are talking Arnab to a person.
You opposed it. What did Buddhadev Bhattacharya do?
You are talking to a person who personally went and addressed 1 lakh people in Nandigram.
What did Buddhadev Bhattacharya do? What did Buddhadev Bhattacharya do?
We compelled him to go back on this issue.
What did he say? He said capital has no color or ideology.
That is all that sometimes some people say it doesn't mean that the you become so wise at a time.
I am only please.
You cannot become a wise.
Watch, Kiran Shah wants to respond to you. 1 minute, sir. Let Kiran Shah respond.
The Communist Party is a collective leadership.
Yes, it is. But that collective leadership allowed the Kishore Biyani headed Big Bazaar Group to launch one of its biggest expansion drives in West Bengal. So basically, you are opposed to Walmart in Delhi.
Kishore Biyani is not the.
So?
Kishore Biyani is not Walmart.
So what is the format? You can have Indian superstores, but you cannot have...
Format is something different. There you can regulate. There you can guide.
Let's get a response.
Who will control Walmart?
Kiran Shah.
Who will control our Walmart?
Kiran Shah is responding.
Why they failed in Germany? What happened to Walmart in Germany?
In fact, I thought your problem was with the format, not with... the nature of the investment alone. Kiran Shah wants to respond to you. Hear the other side. Ms. Shah.
Yeah.
Yeah. First and foremost, I think anyone who says that we can, you know, give a future to Aam Aadmi without proper economic growth, and personally I believe you have to have that 9 to 10% growth to make any difference. Even to give them two chapatis and the vegetables that he's talking about, you need that 10% growth. That's one thing. Secondly, I agree with you, Arnab. What is this hypocrisy? Why is it that we look at Walmart and Big Bazaar with two different eyes? Okay? I think it is very important for us to understand that xenophobia is not going to improve investor confidence in India. Today, investor confidence is at an all-time low. We have seen our FDI decline. We have seen our trade deficit at an all-time low of $70 billion. We have seen a sharp decline in even our exports. I mean, it is an economic crisis. We need investment. So if people are going to believe that we can grow this country without investment, I think it's ridiculous. And 1 minute, we are not talking about who is responsible. We are trying to correct this economic crisis. And we have to do things which regain investor confidence.
Your correctness has brought further popularization.
Let me say one more thing. West Bengal can choose to remain poor. And they will not get investment in West Bengal if this is the rhetoric they use. But that does not mean the whole country has to suffer.
Okay, Gaurav Bhatia, you're here.
Enough food grains.
Let's get Gaurav Bhatia in.
Countries, people are half fed.
Let's get Gaurav Bhatia in. Gaurav, do you have a response to her?
Your policy towards investment is completely
different when it comes to
Arnab,
when it comes to Uttar Pradesh. Yes, go ahead, Gaurav.
What has happened is the way in which FDI in retail has been implemented. Our party, the Samajwadi Party, has been opposing it for various reasons, and let me just spell those out. First of all, It is important to know that FDI in retail is not the same as FDI in aviation, or as the UP Chief Minister Mr. Akhilesh Yadav said that we would welcome FDI in the power sector, in the infrastructure sector. And why we say this is because when we get FDI in retail, the farmers are directly affected. It has not been shown by the UPA that a proper consultative process had been taken. The farmer bodies, or if they have, then which farmer organizations have been consulted, and it has not been also spelled out that what would be the long-term impact of having FDI in retail. And these are very serious questions that the Samajwadi Party is raising. You know, if you have to take such a major decision which would affect many years to come, then it should be a well-thought, well-consulted
okay,
policy.
Let's get, okay,
decision.
We're hearing him in. Now let's welcome Ravi Shankar Prasad joining the debate finally tonight, and with Kiran Majumdar Shaw has been there on the other side. Let's get Kiran Majumdar Shaw and Ravi Shankar Prasad to also lock horns on this one. Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad, before you came in, Kiran Majumdar Shaw making very critical argument, this country needs 10% investment. And I also made the point that, you know, when it comes to Chhattisgarh, Mr. Prasad, then your BJP government welcomes Walmart with open arms in Chhattisgarh. When it comes to Punjab, then your government, which is the Shiromani Akali Dal BJP government, one of the biggest centers of Walmart was opened up in Punjab, in Jalandhar, employing approximately 6,000, 7,000 people. So why this dual standards was my question, and Kiran Majumdar's question specifically is on the need for investment and on the need for you now to give up your obstructionist policies and open up on these fast-track reforms. Mr. Prasad.
First of all, about Chhattisgarh, you're completely wrong, Arno. Yes, in Punjab, there was certain initial proposals, but now the NDA is completely won as far as opposing FDI and retail is concerned. Arno, growth cannot be FDI-centric. And any decision taken in a hurry cannot compensate for the loss of good governance, which is most important, corruption-free decision-making process to propelling growth. Now see, we have a problem in land acquisition. The whole of infrastructure sector, like national highway, like port reform, electricity reform, is in a complete mess. Colgate, I always congratulate you, the way in which you have exposed and brought about the shady deals which have gone in the whole range of coal allocations. We are witnessing the consequence of that. Today we have a report that 1,25,000 crore bank money is involved in all these coal projects which are locked up because of various controversies. Who is going to suffer is a separate chapter altogether. Every reform policy change is not reform. Did we oppose civil aviation investment openly? We only lost certain caveat. It should not be one airline centric. In media also we said that you don't compromise editorial autonomy. As far as Arno FDI in retail is concerned, our objections are very clearly outlined.
So your
5 crore Indians depend upon retail sector for livelihood.
So then
you have brought in FDI in retail without any commitment from USA or Europe on outsourcing, on a whole range of other issues. And Indian economy, manufacturing is down. Industrial production is down. Indian economy, it is very important or no? Indian economy will compete with low-cost economy like Bangladesh, Thailand, Cambodia, Vietnam, Malaysia, China. And they will dump those goods here and further impact on India.
Mr. Prasad.
Therefore, it is not in India's interest. Therefore, we are opposing
Mr.
it.
Mr. Prasad, don't be upset if I were to directly ask you there today. Please don't be upset because I'll ask you a pretty straightforward question. You are putting undue pressure on your allies. You are making them eat their words. You are forcing, you are using your political clout to make them change their policies. And I can show you a letter written by Sukhbir Badal in December 2011 in which he promises complete support to the UPA government. And he says, and I read to Anand Sharma, please tell me this today. We are delighted to hear that your government is taking a major initiative that will offer tremendous benefits to farmers and peoples in my state. Then later, he goes to a village. He goes to a village. He says, you know, problem is with the BJP. They are the ones who are taking a different position. You know, are you thinking of the farmer? Are you pushing your political point across, you know?
I'm very sorry that you should have that inference. Prakash Singh Badal subsequently explained that.
Subsequently?
We have a proper discussion there. Not just a minute, Arnab Goswami. The BJP's record of reform is too well known. On the whole range of pension reforms, on the insurance reform, you know our position as to how we have told this government, please open these sectors subject to certain conditions. They have no problem within inside. But yes, on FDI retail, we have a very serious reservation.
You made them change their position.
You are... Not the least. Consultation is important. I am sure Arnab Goswami also consults with his deputy raters and changes the view at times or make them change their view. Therefore, consultation
you don't
in
force
the NDA
your view and then
be a problem.
Someone else to do a U-turn because you are doing it.
Sorry. Or no, that is a very wrong way of saying that. Today, the NDA is very clearly united. Akali is supporting the Bharat Band.
Okay, then.
But Arnab, I am on a larger, pure economic issue. And allow me to flag that. When you open up FDI in retail, you have taken the biggest gamble. What India has gained in return? Outsourcing is a problem.
Okay.
Has Obama committed?
Okay.
Has Europe committed?
Yeah.
Therefore, you have not got anything in return, yet you have opened it, which is not
in Mr. Prasad, you are opening up the debate tonight, and we will get into areas where you may be on sticky ground, but Kiran Majumdar Shaw disagreeing with you, Kumar Ketkar disagreeing with you, a whole lot of people disagreeing with you tonight, Ravishankar Prasad. Let's give equal opportunity. Kumar
Ketkar. They have got their right.
They have got their right. And that's right. Let's get the points in. Kumar Ketkar fires the first salvo tonight.
See,
go ahead.
Mr. Prasad says that BJP's record is very clear on this.
Yes.
BJP's record was in between 91 and 96. They opposed GATT, they opposed liberalization, they opposed globalization.
Oh.
And after coming to power in 1998, they claimed that the Shining India came because of their opening up policies. They were the defenders of globalization, privatization, liberalization.
And now he's saying
that they're opposing FDI now. I'm 100% certain in case they come to power, which they claim they will be in power, and according to opinion polls, they feel they are in power, they will bring FDI and say that they have done it slightly differently. And Narendra Modi was on record saying that he welcomes FDI, and majority of the NRI community, which is in America, a Gujarati trading community, they also want FDI in India.
So
I think BJP is saying...
One second.
No, BJP talks about governance or about policy.
Okay.
Let me be clear.
Okay, governance.
Let me be clear, or governance or policy. First discuss the policy.
Okay, now